Welcome back to Virtual Reality. My name is Thomas and you're watching Voodoo.de VR. The next episode of the VR and AR Weekly News. What do we have? Ecto-1 boots. These are boots where you can move on place and in virtual reality unlimited. It's really awesome. Then HOTAS systems for Star Wars Squadrons. HP Reverb G2 gets another version called Omni Concept. Then information about Oculus Quest 2 streaming to PC, and Haptics creates a full body force feedback system called ForceBot. Also, you will find the newest releases and sales this week. As always, thank you to my sponsors, Woodgoes VR, Oppermann Events, Peter Wasmeyer, Andy de Felser, VR Ambassador and Virtual Escape. Let's have some fun with the video and let's go! Voodoo.de. Look at these boots. they play Half-Life Alyx with them. And see that? See this guy here wearing this big boots? And he's walking in one place. And in virtual reality, he's walking through a house in Half-Life Alyx. And this is amazing. It looks really cool. So under the boots, there are like wheels, and they turn in the opposite direction where you walk, and that means you feel that you're walking forward, for example, but you stay in one place, and that's awesome. So you can walk infinite in virtual reality, but you don't need much space at home, and that's awesome. Only thing is that for now it's only for enterprise and it's still prototype, and these things look really bulky and heavy, so it's not for us at home, at least not now, but the concept is awesome. So I tried a lot of treadmills and I didn't like them. The best one was the Infinadek, but it's so expensive, so ultra heavy and big, it's nothing for home. But this one perhaps one day could be for at home. There are some questions. Can I jump with that? Can I crouch with that or stuff? What's when I stop instantly and move backward? Does that work or will I fall on the ground? I have no idea. Questions over questions. But I love this concept and I wrote to the company if I can try them somewhere. I hope they will respond and I can try it somewhere in Europe, or at least perhaps they can even send them to me for 1 week or something like that so that I can try them. It's nice. What do you think about that? Does this have a future? Write it in the comments below. So yeah, Star Wars Squadrons. Perhaps you've seen my gameplay. I'm sorry again that I was not able to show it to you for more than 10 minutes because just this this roll to left and right, it makes me motion sick. I have no idea why. I can stand all the stuff that I can play like roller coasters in VR. I can play Serious Sam with fastest movement speed. No problem for me. But this rolling to left and right, I can't stand it. Perhaps it's why because I use the here the thumbsticks of the Xbox controller. I have no idea, but even with the HOTAS, it causes motion sickness for me. So I'm really sorry about that, but the game is awesome itself. Of course, it's Star Wars. It feels great to sit in the cockpit of X-Wing or TIE Fighter. And here is a cool list by Upload VR of cool flight sticks and HOTAS. And one of them I also have at home, the Thrustmaster T16000M FCS. I have that at home and I can tell you this is really great because separate pieces and you can place them wherever you want and it just feels good. For me at least. I'm not a pro gamer in simulations, but for me they feel really good. And if you want to buy them, you can find it in the description and in the first comment pinned, then you can buy them. There are some others listed here, but I can't tell you if they are good. Just check them out in the description and perhaps they are better for you or cheaper. No idea. There are some from Logitech or other from Thrustmaster. This one is even very expensive. No idea, but at least the first one I can tell you is awesome. So if you want to play Star Wars Squadrons or upcoming Flight Simulator 2020 in VR with HOTAS or flight sticks, then you should do that. It's much more immersive. So check the description and the first pinned comment for the HOTAS systems. So besides the HP Reverb G2 that's shipping in end of October or November when you pre-ordered it already, there is a new one that's called HP Reverb G2 Omni Concept, but this is only for developer and enterprise clients, and Omni Concept Edition has eye tracking integrated. That means you can see where the user is looking and also use it for foveated rendering. And also there's a face tracking camera that not only scans the eyes, but your whole face. So it can see when your lips are moving or when you smile. And this data can be used for whatever, and also used for the virtual avatar that moves like yourself. And there's a heart rate tracker. So all your body data is tracked with the headset and can be used for marketing or whatever. Whatever. Also, there's an SDK for developers and better support, of course. And the thing will be released in spring 2021. It will be very expensive, I'm pretty sure, and I will not order it for me at home, but when I have the chance to try it somewhere, I will do that. The normal HP Reverb G2 I already pre-ordered, and I will do a cool review about this as soon as possible, and then we will see if this thing is really good. What I absolutely dislike with Windows Mixed Reality headsets are these controllers. I hate them. I don't like them. I really hope that the headset at least is really good and you can use it for simulations or stuff. We will see. So when the Oculus Quest 2 will be released on October 13th, it will have wireless streaming support, native support. The Oculus support confirmed that to me, but it will not have 90 Hertz at release. So this is, it will be released in upcoming updates or what, but when you use the virtual desktop app that you can buy on Steam, you can use the 90 Hertz directly at release of Oculus Quest 2. That's awesome. It's a third party app, and you just connect it wireless, and then you can play like Half-Life Alyx on the Quest 2 wireless. And that's awesome because not many headsets, not even the Valve Index, the Pimax, or the Reverb G2 support wireless streaming or wireless stuff. Only thing is the Vive headsets with the Vive wireless adapter, but that's a different price class. It's much more expensive. And I'm really impressed what you can do with the Oculus Quest 2. You can do it with the Quest 1 as well, but only with, what was that, 72 Hertz, right? And this one, the new one, will support 90 Hertz. It's great. Do you plan to use the Quest 2 wireless? Write it in the comments below. So the company Haptics that produced VR gloves has now raised $1.5 million to create a full body haptic system for VR. And that is, and even for robots. And that's really impressive because you will feel at first, the whole body is tracked, of course, every piece of your body is tracked, every piece. And then you can even feel when you hit an object with your elbow or whatever, you can feel it, and you can even control the robots and stuff. It's so great. And of course that will only be for enterprise at the beginning, because it will be ultra expensive, I'm sure. So we cannot use it at home, but perhaps for some VR arcades, high-end VR arcades that want to have a magnet for guests, it will be very interesting. The thing, the system is called ForceBot. What do you think about it? Is it interesting, or is it just a waste of money? Write it in the comments below. Let's check out the releases this week on Steam. We have The Walking Dead Onslaught. This is an arcade zombie shooter. I don't like it. I already played it. It's just too arcade, too simple, and no fun at all. Then we have Hell Road VR. This is also a zombie shooter. We are on a motorbike and we shoot zombies from the motorbike. Interesting. Then Star Wars Squadrons. It's as I already said, it's not the kind of game that I like, but I know that people love it. If you want to play it with a HOTA system, check out the first comment and the description. You will see the links to good HOTA systems. Space shooter. Then we have Photo Studio. You can take pictures of women. Whoever needs that, I don't know. Then on the Oculus Quest, we have Until You Fall. This is a really cool melee action game where you fight mystic enemies. It's good. I already played it. Then on the Rift, Operencia, The Stolen Sun. This is an old school dungeon crawler. I already played that and I don't like it because of the controls. It makes you motion sick and it doesn't make sense at all. the movement and the user interface. Then also The Walking Dead Onslaught on Rift. Harvest VR, this is a farming simulation. It's for free on the Rift. And 51 Aliens TV, this is a music visualization platform. So the creatures and all the stuff moves in the rhythm of the music. Then on the PlayStation VR, we have The Walking Dead Onslaught as well. And Until You Fall as well on the PlayStation VR. Thanks to my new supporter this week, Plinzler, via Patreon. If you want to support me as well, check out my Patreon link in the description. And from $1 per month, you can see behind the scenes videos and early access videos to my videos. Early access versions to my videos. So let's check out the sales. Windlands 2 on Steam. This is a game with grappling hooks, you have to reach the next platform. 50% off. Then The Curious Tale of the Stolen Pets is a really cute adventure with hidden items. 50% off. Tower Tag, it's a cool multiplayer shooter where you have to conquer platforms. 70%. Then Final Approach, this is a strategy game with airplanes. 50% off. Synth Riders, a music rhythm game, 40% off on the Oculus Quest. Pixel Rip 1995, this is a cool retro adventure. 25% off on the Rift, Super Hot VR, an action game, 54% off. Windlands 2, also on Rift, 50% off. And on the PlayStation VR, Final Fantasy Fishing Spin-Off, Monster of the Deep, 50% off. Yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys, and check out the links in the description and in the first pinned comment, what you can find here with perhaps the HOTAs and stuff. Thank you for watching. Give me thumbs up. See you next time. Bye.